top two flyweights get to go for Olympic gold. Joel Gonzalez Bonilla of Spain against the Korean Lee Daehoon. Of a long day. Lee Daehoon has had some very, very good scraps along the way. That opening encounter against Pennet Karaket, match of the first round, scores level after three rounds. Korean nabbed the golden score. And to sudden death as well in the quarterfinal. Stones, featuring the Spaniard Joel Gonzalez Bonilla in the blue, and in the red a Korean. He called himself a world champion, the Korean, so's the Spaniard. But there's nothing quite like being able to call yourself an Olympic champion, and that's what's up for grabs here between these two. In Barcelona, the 22-year-old who strikes first.
Yep, in terms of the tail of the tape, they're a carbon copy physically. Length of leg, ability to control the distance has been better managed though by Bonilla with the body shot. I don't think the head shot was that convincing, but the Spanish athlete has asked for his coach to play the video replay card.
So this is one of the new innovations that we've seen brought into the sport since Beijing, when lots of us would have last seen it for a prolonged period of time. The ability of the coach to play this card, the blue card, or the red card, if it happens to be the Korean who wants to have a look, just challenge the decision, just to have a quick sneak at the video replay to see if something was missed. Now, did the Spaniard in the blue connect with the head? He did, and it's a very good call.
Bonilla signaled to his coach saying that he believes there was sufficient impact, and as you can see, there certainly was. And that's why it's such a great innovation, Nick, because in terms of transparency and fairness, if the good men of the trio here get it correct, yep, Dennis Ojo of France has upheld it.
Well, we all remember the moment 4 years ago when Sarah Stevenson seemed to have been done in cold blood when she almost knocked the Chinese opponent's head off, and it wasn't given, and it led to all sorts of shenanigans and us looking at shut doors for 45 minutes while decisions were arrived at. And the big fallout of moments like that are what we've just seen, the video replay, and it clears things up immediately, and it has made the sport more transparent, and it means that the Spaniard is ahead by 3 points.
Deservedly so, but a nice little shot from Lee Daehoon on the way through, cancelled out again by Joel Gonzalez Bonilla. It's 5-1. This is a pulsating start to this match. Usually you get quite an impasse between the two, but these guys are wasting no time at all.
So just reminders of the scoring, two major areas, the torso and the head.
Sure, the little sensor socks that they have on their feet have to match up to the body armour. If they do that with power and impact, they'll get 1 point. If they kick to the face, they'll get three. If they add in any spin of difficulty, you double it up. You get 2 points to the body, 4 points to the face. And the good old-fashioned right hand or left hand punch to the body is just a simple point.
And now we've already seen the video replay, one of Taekwondo's newest inventions. We're having a look at the other one as well, which is the body arm, the electronic body arm, which wasn't quite ready for Beijing. They talked about it, but they weren't happy with the way it was operating, but it is operating now. And when the little sensors on the socks that the athletes all have to wear now connect with the requisite force on that body armor, then it's chalked up automatically on the scoreboard. So it means that the judges don't have to look for that now. They're just looking for the headshots, which are the tougher ones to see, and the more important ones as well. They're the ones that win contests, and at the moment, it's the headshot from the Spaniard early on in that first round that has him ahead at the end of it in this gold medal contest.
Definitely, the game changers are indeed the headshots, as you rightly called it, and Gonzalez Bonilla, he came straight out of the blocks there with a great headshot, very quick. Just caught Daehoon a little bit unawares, and that is the reason for the three-point gap at this moment. But as we know, games can change very quickly, and Daehoon has been in good form all day. He will not be giving this up for a fight because he has the variety. Here we can see the simple body shot in the beginning from Bonilla. Little bit of lack of accuracy from the Korean there, doesn't get the sensor sock onto the body. There's the headshot, perfect angle of it. Bonilla knows how much that means. The Korean returned the favour. There's the sensor sock connecting with the body.
Something no other European has ever done. Pitching to win Spain's first ever Taekwondo gold medal under a weight that has never normally been friendly to the Europeans, the flyweights.
It wasn't friendly in the last contest. His teammate Bridget Yagley came up short with the silver. He will not want to do the same. But it's Daehoon trying to get into the ascendancy, but stepping out of range. Every time he plays one shot, Nick, he steps back out, and that leaves an option to be hit. Can't go there. Very powerfully administered by Aruban referee Jose Eduardo Canelio. And it's 5-3.
The language we use for the sport is Korean, because it's the country where it was dreamt up in the 1950s. Korean in this final, and Kyungo is Korean for penalty or something approximating.
Absolutely,
penalty,
yep, deduction. Yep. There's a real bad boy penalty called a Gamjon, that's a full point off, but thankfully we don't see that too often.
It's Korean. Country who covers this sport, but they've yet to win a medal in this weight, so something has to give. Either Korea or Spain have to win at the end of this contest, and that will be a little moment of Taekwondo history. During its fourth Olympics, this sport, it made its debut as a full medal sport in Sydney 12 years ago. Half a century after some clever Koreans had dreamt it up by amalgamating various strands of martial arts that they've all been playing.
Tried to tie together those strands as Daehoon, he manages it on this occasion. Lovely simple tunnel kick to the body, tries another one. Bonilla, he's up for the fight here. He's bullying and bossing the Korean around. He knows that Daehoon has to boil down, has to lose the weight. And Bonilla, of all things, is just a natural body type in that way. He doesn't have to diet at all. Whereas Daehoon has to diet to get to 63, let alone 58. So the physical advantage in favour of the Spaniard at the moment, likewise the scoreboard.
Just though, it's tightened up in this second round. 20 seconds of it left. Problems with the knee. Once again, the magic gas comes out. And we're running around like a spring chicken very shortly.
Chabuni means calm down, calm down.
Daehoon, the Korean, Gonzalez Bonilla. Returned his European crown in Manchester earlier this year. 100 miles further south, he's going for Olympic glory.
Power as well from Bonilla, and it's those power shots underneath. He's picked off four in a row now, and this has turned into a proper fight at the end of the second round.
Debbie, one or two watching though, he saw Lee Daehoon fly through with his own left-footed kick to the body, and that didn't count. What's going on there?
Well, it's as much about kicking as it is about covering, because you have to drop your arms. This might be the most important thing. Why do they hang their arms by the side? Why don't they punch? The arms are as close as they possibly can to protect the body and mitigate the impact. And Bonilla has been better at covering, and he has been leaning back on his shots, given a smaller target, and blazing in with some power shots at him. That's why he takes those 4 points. He did trade off with better shots from the Spanish athlete. You watch the hands there. The hands are down every time. See the hands take the shots. So it's like a boxer taking it on his gloves. The impact is not coming through. That one did though. That one registered to make a 6-4. So kicking and covering is the key. Spanish gold.
Maybe. Well, Gonzalez Bonilla is certainly the favourite, leading by 4 points with a couple of minutes left in this Olympic final. The final cut starts. It seems a little bit late getting underway. Let's hope that something dramatic doesn't happen right at the end.
Exactly. And what a difference 2 seconds can make in these matches. There's the punch from Bonilla, the attempted headshot from Lee Daehoon, decks it in the process. That Kungo could prove costly, 9-4 in favour of Joel Gonzalez Bonilla.
He took up the sport 11 years ago when his dad opened his own Taekwondo training centre. Seemed a decent way of spending his spare time, and he's 5 points up again. Every time the Korean thinks about getting back in range, the Spaniard pulls away, but Korean back within 4 points now.
Well, this could be the aforementioned bad boy Ganjon. If you attack before the referee says it's time to go, it's a full point off. If the referee's job is the safety of the fighters, good job there.
We'll back up to 5.
Oh! There's the knockout shot! There's the knockout shot.
That was a face full of foot.
Yeah. Only fools rush on it, and he did. He gave it everything he had, he forgot about his footwork, he forgot about his guard. And in the Olympic final, to see a headshot of that class, speed and power, well, it's only meritorious that Bonilla should be 14-7 to the good.
Well, he's struggling to remember anything at the moment, having just taken that clock to the bonce.
Yeah, there's a bit of blood here, I think.
He's trying to recall his own name. That was an almighty hit, the biggest hit of the day.
And don't get confused here, the Korean coach is actually saying there was a 3-point shot from Lee Daehoon after it. He's not pretending that the calamitous headshot that Bonilla threw wasn't a shot. He's saying that in the mix there was a headshot from the Korean.
On dodge request, 3 points,
he is now playing his card. He'll get to hang on to it if the television officials agree with him.
But what a power shot that was.
That's the best we've seen all day. Best we've seen all day.
Because a lot of times you look at matches and think, oh, why don't they go? Why don't they keep kicking? That's why.
From a man, by the way, who said before he came into today that Taekwondo wasn't a violent sport. It's about being quicker, more agile, more intelligent. Strategy.
What was violent about that?
And then he goes and clocks somebody straight in
the head down, not concentrating, the Korean looking and the head's wide open.
Goodbye. And he did well to recover quite as quickly as he did. But we're looking for a Korean response to see whether what he did in the build-up to that was worth any points himself.
Yeah, after that there was a flurry of kicks, but well, more in hope than expectation, I think, from the Korean coach, and a chance to get his athlete's nose sorted out.
But it's the appeal was unsuccessful, but it may well have done its job if the primary objective was to give Lee Daehoon a little bit of time to clear his head. Less than 40 seconds to go, though, in this Olympic final. And Korean has got to be as spectacular as he's ever been in his career if he's to rescue this, and he's fallen further behind.
In the exchanges every time, Bonilla more accurate, more composed. Daehoon doesn't have his problems to see. Takes another Kyungo to join the shot in the face that he took. And Joel Gonzalez Bonilla, Nick, he's been the best athlete all day, and certainly in this final, he's shown what Olympic Taekwondo is all about. Stepping out of the ring there, doesn't really care, he'll take that Kyungo all day. There's the Cam John for kicking after Kallio. Well, we've seen everything now, Nick.
I think the Spaniard is asking for his coach to use the card, but before that can come out, we're going to have a little confab of the officials. Now, what's this about?
Well, you're absolutely right. Joe Gonzalez Bonilla asked his coach to play the video replay card, saying that there was an infringement after the kick. However, the Spanish coach, wise to it, realised that the judges had it in hand, and let's see what they come up with here. 1 point taken off. I think they gave a spinning point, extra point, for one of the kicks that was thrown there by Daehoon.
So what was 17-9 is now 17-8. And if it wasn't desperate for the Korean, it's now whatever more than desperate is. 10 seconds to go. 10 seconds away from Spain and their first ever Taekwondo gold medalist. And victory for Europe in a division that has been barren for them up to this point. The only man in London tonight who will be rewarded for kicking somebody else in the head. And how well he did it. That was a gold medal winning kick. And the Olympic champion comes from Spain, Joel Gonzalez Bonilla. He's seen off the challenge of the Korean, Daehoon, who for large parts of that contest didn't know what day it was. That's Taekwondo, John. There is an element of intelligence about it, an element of strategy, but ultimately it's about kicking another boy very hard in the head and getting the point.
Brute force and ignorance always supersede strategy. Once you've got that technique and that base put in place, when you have a lead, Daehoon put his head down, didn't concentrate, walked into the most perfect exhibition of what a Taekwondo kick is. And as you said, Nick, this is a little bit of history for the Spanish team.
Their first Taekwondo Olympic champion.
It's been tremendous entertainment. We've seen a lot of pushing kicks, a lot of blocking, covering, dropping the hands, the kind of dark arts of Taekwondo that only the experts would appreciate, but that is good old-fashioned, old-school kick into the face.
And we love it.
Do join us.